Deputy McGrath.
Thank you, Concorda. Concorda, first of all, can I join with you and the Taoiseach and Deputy Gerry Adams, the Éamon Gcaoimh, in offering our sympathy on behalf of the technical group to Micheál Martin and his family. Today, Taoiseach, I'd like to raise another serious matter, the decision on the EU decision to ban oil imports from Iran and its serious consequences for the Irish economy, energy costs, motorists and consumers, but also the implications for Ireland's foreign policy, particularly in the Middle East. So can I ask you, first of all, Taoiseach, in relation to this proposed oil ban, when was this decision made by our own government? Did the Cabinet collectively decide on this ban? And why did you make that decision? Can I also, Taoiseach, did you think out the consequences for Irish customers, motorists, the markets and, above all, Irish jobs? Do you accept, Taoiseach, that the vast majority of the Irish people do not support this action, and particularly ending our foreign independent policy of neutrality by following Cameron, Sarkozy, Merkel and the US on this sabre-type rattling? And finally, Taoiseach, do you not think it's a bit rich for nuclear powers like Britain, the US, Israel or France to be lecturing Iran about nuclear power and weapons when they themselves are up to their necks in nuclear weapons? And isn't it time, Taoiseach, for common sense and dialogue between all nations that have nuclear weapons? And surely, Taoiseach, can you accept that dialogue is the way forward, not punishing the Irish people, the consumers, the motorists, and not punishing the Iranian people? Thank you, Concorda.
Thank you, Deputy. Taoiseach.
Well, Deputy McGrath was always a strong supporter of human rights, and he's rightly raised questions here about the implications of activities by the Taliban and Al-Qaeda and other groups. This is an EU support for sanctions against Iran because of the scale and the proliferation of their activities in regard to nuclear power. And it's for that reason that the European Union, including Ireland, and the Taoiseach on behalf of the government, supports the sanctions being imposed on Iran in this case. The reports, as of this morning, I haven't heard them in the last hour or so, indicated that there wasn't that much of a reaction because of the protection that exists in respect of the Straits of Hormuz, both by the American fleet and elsewhere. Clearly, of course, Deputy, if this sanction regime were to continue for an extended period, and there was to be a drop in oil supplies, then clearly prices would rise, not just in Ireland, but everywhere else as well. But this is a case, Deputy McGrath, of a serious matter of an expansion of a nuclear program by Iran, and as a consequence, sanctions being extended against that country, which the European Union strongly support. It is my hope that there would not be any catastrophic consequences in that region. Clearly, oil and its importance in terms of the economies of Western Europe and other countries is critical. And for that reason, I think that there is a belief that there is sufficient capacity to see that the straits are kept opened for traffic to countries in the West, including Ireland.